And we are finally back with the Honda. It has been a long time that this thing has been off camera. Actually, we haven't really worked on it much, believe it or not, off camera either. We got this thing, I think, at the end of the winter, and we made that little bit of intro video on it. We talked about it rolling into the shop. We show you guys, Susan started stripping this thing way back when we first got it, just because, if you've never heard me talk about it before, any car that I have sitting, especially if it's sitting outside, always strip your interior first thing. Get it gutted out, trunk empty, interior empty, because that keeps a lot of those critters from moving into your vehicles. You may not think it, but it makes a huge difference. And I'm telling you right now, I've never ever had a mouse problem with any derby car that has been stripped out in the interior and trunk while leaving it outside. Even the Buick LeSabre that we are building, the 04 Buick there, that thing sat outside for 3 years, went through a flood, all kinds of stuff, but because the interior was empty, nothing really made nests in it, nothing destroyed any wires whatsoever. So we did that for the Honda early on when we got this thing. Other than that, it's been sitting outside the entire time. But now it's crunch time. That is right, we're building double vehicles at the same time. We're building this vehicle here and the other one that I'm going to be running. Susan has a vehicle and I have one. If you didn't hear yet, she will be running this Honda. So this is a 2001 Honda. So the very end of this style of the Honda generation. Still mixed feelings about how this thing's going to do for us. Susan has been converted. She's hopped over. She is on the bandwagon for Hondas, guys. She thinks they're tough stuff now. She's seen this thing down, stripped down, and she's happy with it. So we'll see if it can prove her right, prove me wrong, or if it's going to go out real early on. I hope not. I hope this thing gets destroyed. So quick update on the car. What is going on? Where is this running? This is actually going to be running in my team demolition derby that I'm hosting at the Circle City Raceway. You heard me talk about it before in the video. Multiple teams are all signed up. That is happening July 4th weekend. It's a two-day event. We got heats on a Friday. We got the feature and normal derbies on a Saturday. So I'm not running in the derby because, of course, I am in charge of that derby. I'm running tech, flagging, everything like that. But Susan did get asked to be on somebody else's team because they needed a third person. So she said, why not? So they've all been building all of this. They're going to be running, I think it's an all Honda team. So stay tuned on that. You're going to be seeing their team cars. We might get all three of them here on our property that weekend of the event. If we can get some footage, I'm not sure yet. So stay tuned on that update as well. But it is a very quick build for this Honda because unfortunately we got busy with a bunch of other stuff amongst running and building other cars that we only have a couple weeks to get this entire Honda built. What you see in front of me right now, this is pretty much a day and a half of work already of just out here stripping and going ham on the front of this thing. So we've tore off the front bumper. We've done the bare minimum already up here under here. I'm moving wiring as we speak on these Hondas. I'm going to give you guys a complete rundown once I actually move everything and simplify a bit under the hood to show you the end result. But just right now, what we're going through, currently figuring out how we can keep the power steering, get it relocated without it being, there's the actual power steering line that was out front here. I've managed to suck that up into the car. I may shorten that line, wrap it up out of the way. I would love to keep this reservoir and move it out of the way somewhere safe if we can. The alternator in this car is junk. It is actually seized and cracked all the way through. My guess is maybe a bearing went out and it locked up, cracked this when the belt turned tight, snapped the belt in the car. That was one of the reasons the owner got rid of this in the first place, is relating back to that. I don't know if we're going to switch it out and run an alternator at all, or we're just going to run it off the battery. Because honestly, I'm pretty certain we're not running cooling fans regardless. Radiator is still yet to be determined. We may run a radiator, we may just loop it, because these Honda engines, you guys know them, they will run one heck of a long time with just looped lines. And usually these team shows, you know, the heats are very fast paced, so it's probably not going to overheat during that short time. The main debate with the alternator is, here's the catch. If you put an alternator on it, then yes, you now have it charging your battery, and when this thing finally gets hot enough to shut down, melt down, whatever the case, you're going to want all the power in your battery that you can get to refire this engine. Because if it is that hot to start shutting down, then you know this Honda engine is crazy hot because of how long it takes to shut down. So you're going to want that power. Now here's the other kicker. The way these alternators are set up, and I've already undone the bolt right here, so usually your actual thick cable is bolted right here on the front of this alternator. I've actually thrown them out of the way. Right here's the wiring harness. You see all this stuff right here? That would be sitting right on the end of that guy. So if you have that on here, as soon as your core support, which is very thin on these style of Hondas, pushes in, the first thing it's going to contact is this post sticking out like a big lightning rod of a spear on this alternator, and that is positive power. That means there's a ton of current going through, and as soon as your radiator, your metal core support, your hood, whatever, contacts into that, it is going to short out. It is going to blow sparks everywhere, potentially start a fire. If not, it's going to melt down the cable on that alternator, completely burn the cable up, catch it on fire. Or, worst case scenario, it's actually going to short out, melt down, arc its way all the way back to your battery, and it will completely melt down, fry your battery, your car will shut down, be done for the Derby, and you're out a battery because it fried the entire thing. So, a lot of bad things can go wrong from that. That's why a lot of people I talk to, they just toss these straight in the trash right away. Do not run them on their Hondas. So, not my car that I'm building. This will be Susan's car again for the Team Derby. So, she's making all the calls on this. I'm just overseeing to see if she doesn't, you know, do something wrong. But other than that, it's exact same rules as our Speedrun rules. Very stock class stuff. There's going to be no big welding reinforcing. Just throw in a four-point cage, weld a bumper on the front, and that's pretty much it. You'll send it as is into the Derby. So, that's kind of my thought process on the front right now. We'll go ahead and get our battery cables moved next on this guy. As you can see, this is a very clean car. I know I showed you it early on when we were just getting started on it, but now it's really opened up. I can show you. This thing is a black frame all the way, front to back. The only rust I've ever found is just a little bit of surface rust right here where your battery tray bolted in. So, not surprised to see a little bit of rust there. Other than that, subframe is solid, unibody frame rails are solid, strut towers are good. You work your way along the car. We still have the plastic cover. Let's see if the rockers are rotten. I'm going to guess not, you know, considering the rest of this car, but we'll get those pulled off. The interior on this thing is almost completely done, it looks like. She does have the back seat out of it. She's got the passenger seat out of it. She's been busy working on this. I have not really done a lot to this vehicle. Only thing left really is just a little bit of the dash. We're going to pull the glove box, airbags, and go ahead and get this carpet moved out of here. A little bit of door panels over there as well. Looks like we got to pull them off. Other than that, it's about ready for the cage, which I will do for her since I want to make sure that thing's going to hold up plenty strong for a team show. Rolling around to the back trunk. You see here it is just as clean as the front. Nothing rotted out on the floor. Quarters are solid. We are allowed to go ahead and notch a pre-bend. I think she may even keep the back bumper. This is entirely different than something I would normally build. You guys know me, I'm pretty notorious for throwing all of my bumpers in the trash, or at the very least, cutting the middle section out of them and keeping both corner rails to help them roll up. But with this being a foreign car, essentially anything that is a Toyota, a Volkswagen, a Honda, even sometimes you get into your Kias, a lot of that stuff naturally goes up or straight in. You don't even need to notch it, and they seem to do so well in these bone stock shows with the frame. So with that being said, she may keep it on here, just give it a good notch and let this thing roll right in, pack in for her. We'll discuss that in future videos as we get the trunk of this car built. But I know she's been busy working away, so I wanted to just buzz out here and give you an update on the Honda before she gets too far along with it and we can't even catch everything going on. So stay tuned on further progress of this. I'll give you an update once the front has been put back together as far as components and whatnot. I'll show you the official routing that we got figured out. And then figure out what kind of bumper's going on the front of this thing. We've got a couple options to use. Remember, no full-size chrome bumpers for any of these shows. These are stock shows, so it's got to be some kind of a rebar, you know, a bumper reinforcement. Anything like that, we'll pick through, see what's best for this vehicle. Well, there you guys have it, the 01 Honda going into the Derby World to try something new.